There's nothing quite like opening night.
For us people that love hockey, it's like Christmas Day.
These guys are so excited to get going.
It's a fresh season.
Everyone's hopeful.
Sit back, soak it all in.
So you get back to what you want to be doing, and that's playing hockey games.
The building's bumping a little more than usual.
It almost feels like a playoff game.
The fans can't believe what they just saw.
Hockey has arrived with no shortage of storylines.
Pastrnak is there. He scores!
It's time to raise the championship banner to the Raptors.
The Cup is in the building again in Florida. For the first time in franchise history, the Panthers raise a Stanley Cup banner. PA announcer Andrew Imber.
Champion Florida Panthers!
Shot of the Panthers there, arm in arm, celebrating, watching that banner being raised to the rafters for the first time in Panther history. Alongside Ryan Callahan, I'm John Butchergoss, coming to you from Bristol, Connecticut. We decided with the approaching storm in Florida to return our ESPN family home to broadcast this game for you tonight out of an abundance of caution. You never know which way the storm could turn. Also didn't want to be a burden any first responders in case they had to do their job. And certainly our thoughts are with the people all along the west coast of Florida, from Naples to Sarasota up to Tampa. It looks like a big one, and our thoughts are with you. We hope everything turns out as best as possible. So, Ryan, we see the Florida Panthers raise that Stanley Cup banner for the first time. I have goosebumps, and I'm not even there. Big challenge, though, to go back-to-back. What's the biggest one?
I think the biggest one is the subtractions on defense and how do they replace them. There's Oliver Ekman-Larsson, and most importantly, Brandon Montour is a huge part of this team offensively in the room. And they went out and got Adam Boqvist, and a guy that was bought out from Columbus, but I think they're hoping big things from him. He's going to start on PP1 for the Florida Panthers, and maybe they can strike gold again, kind of like they did with Forsling when they took him off of waivers. We'll see what happens with this D, but I'll tell you what, those are two big pieces that they're going to miss.
Meanwhile, on offense, though, they return 8 of their 9 top forwards, and it might be the best in the league.
It is, and that's the core that won them the Stanley Cup. These guys play hard. They're in your face. They can score goals. It's a nightmare for a defenseman when they have this group forechecking against you, and now they have the confidence of winning a Stanley Cup. The question is, they're saying the right things heading into the start of the season, but now can they get on the ice, and can they repeat?
Meanwhile, the Boston Bruins had a very public contract negotiation with Jeremy Swayman. Eventually, it gets done, but it just got done this weekend, so he won't start tonight. Jonas Korpisalo will, the guy they got for Linus Ullmark in the offseason trade. I'm sure Swayman was trying to get Jim Montgomery to play him tonight. What do you think?
Yeah, he's definitely trying to get him to play. I mean, he's a number one guy, but I love this decision by Jim Montgomery. Don't put him in net. He was not there for training camp. He had no preseason games. He was practicing with Boston University, but that's not an NHL training camp. You just signed him a $66 million deal. Make sure he's ready to go. I'm sure he'll be in next game.
Meanwhile, the Bruins add Elias Lindholm from Vancouver, free agent signing. Nikita Zadorov as well. It just seems like a lot of Bruins moves, Ryan, are with Florida in mind. Makes sense. They knocked them out the last 2 years. The Bruins are a big team all of a sudden.
Yeah, they are. And Zadorov, 6'6", 250. He's huge on defense. And I just mentioned the Florida Panthers, how they forecheck, how they grind. A guy like Zadorov, you know, that deters that a little bit. Now all of a sudden you got Zadorov back there. You're not running around as much. That's a huge add for Boston. The big question, though, Fuchs, is where is they going to find their scoring? Hopefully Lindholm can get back to his days in Calgary. We'll see what happens with Boston, but they have to score goals this year.
Yeah, Charlie Coyle had a career-high 25 last year. They're looking for more from him. Opening face-off moments away here on ESPN Game 2 of our triple header, opening night triple header, as we saw the St. Louis Blues take care of Seattle in game number 1. And game number 2 coming up here from Florida, it's the Panthers and the Boston Bruins with Game 3, first game in the history of the Utah Hockey Club, as they are home in Salt Lake City for the very first time against Connor Bedard and the Chicago Blackhawks. Again, it's Korpisalo versus Bobrovsky tonight in net for this game between the Panthers and the Bruins, as PA announcer Andrew Imber announcing the starting lineups of the Panthers and the Bruins.
It is Musa presented once again.
John Puchegross and Ryan Callahan with you for the Bruins and the Panthers. Time now for our Honda starting goalies. Again, it's Jonas Korpisalo in net for the Bruins, acquired in the Linus Ullmark trade with Ottawa. They also got Mark Kastelic in that trade. He starts as your fourth line center. And Sergei Bobrovsky, 36 years old, 4 wins from 400. He'll just be the 14th guy to do that. 2 Vezinas, a cup. He's on his way to the Hall of Fame.
Yeah, there's no question about that. A lot of concern early on about his contract, but he proved that he's a Stanley Cup winner last year.
Again, Korpisalo in net because the contract negotiations with Jeremy Swayman did not end until this weekend. That's a $66 million smile right there.
Not a $64 million one,
no.
A $66 million smile, Booch.
But he is the guy for the first time, and we'll get into that tonight. For the first time, he's the guy. Those shoulders will be a little heavier. The last 2 years, the Bruins have had the best goaltending situation in the NHL. The best save percentage the last 2 years. But Ullmark is now in Ottawa, and we are underway in Florida.